Hey guys, I'm back with another episode on kitchen gardening. And guess what? Today I am going to grow potatoes and capsicums here in my balcony. So let's get started. To grow potatoes and capsicum, you will require sprouted potatoes and capsicum seeds. To get these, you don't have to additionally buy anything from the market. I'm using what I have at home. So these potatoes were left unused for a couple of days and they have got these sprouts. You can see they are little tumors of potato and they are best for growing. And for the capsicums, I'd got capsicums for making salads. So I've saved the most matured seeds, if you can see, for growing purpose. Also, I have taken one green chili and red chili seeds too. So let's see which one grows better. Both of these are going to take similar time to grow, nearly 10 weeks, that's 70 days or more before we harvest them. So let's get started. I have my pots ready for planting, and for those who have missed the episode on how to make your own potting mix, kindly have a look at the previous episodes. The link is shared below. So now let's get started with planting these potatoes. What I'm going to do is I have cut these potatoes into halves. You have to plant the flat portion on the soil like this and the sprouts on the upper side. So I'm going to put four, that's two potatoes in one pot. Like this. So again, there you go. Flat portion in the soil. Alright, these are the potatoes, and for the chilies, I'm going to just put these randomly. These are a lot of seeds, but once they are growing, few of them will grow healthy and few of them will not. So you will have to pluck the ones which are growing healthy and plant them in a bigger pot. Right now I am using this flat tray type pot. So they are good for seedling purpose. Alright, so now what I will do is I will gently put this potting mix above the potatoes. It's pretty lightweight, so it will not affect the sprouts. So just cover them like this. So this work is basically a bit of a patience task. You have to gently do it and be patient about obtaining the fruit out of it after a long wait. But this simple step can add as a huge change, or you know, in your lifestyle as an healthy option. So I believe the change starts from yourself. It starts from your home. So why not? There you go. This pod is ready. And one more final thing. Just be very gentle and equally distribute the soil. There you go. Great. Now I'm going to cover, just putting all the seeds I have left and just evenly distribute them, and I'm going to cover them lightly with hardly 1 inch of level of soil in it now, because these are very gentle and they will sprout within a week's time. So don't cover it too much. Just enough, about enough that it's covered, yeah? Okay. Now, I have these cardboard markers that I have made with similar dates on. So I'm just going to put them like this. Put them here. This end. Okay. And the capsicum one in the side. They're easily decomposable. You can use wooden sticks, wooden spoons or ice cream sticks too. So they are ready. Now I'm going to use my reused bottle as a sprinkler. Just gently water them. Very little, just enough for the day. Guys, in my next following videos, I'm going to keep you updated about the growth of these plants. So stay tuned and kindly like, share and subscribe. Sayonara.